The Raspberry Pi device, in its first incarnation, is a bare circuit board, without a case, without a power supply or anything. You need an SD card with a software image, such as the Fedora remix image that we're releasing. It's small enough that it will fit on a 2 GB SD card. That software provides a fairly complete environment. It provides a graphical user interface, some programming tools, some system administration tools, and some basic applications so that you can use the Pi for some things right out of the box. In one scenario, and probably a very common scenario, people will plug the Raspberry Pi board into a television or a computer monitor, plug in a keyboard and mouse. After that, it will take them directly into the login mode, and they can type in their name and password, and they'll use it as you would use a desktop computer or a laptop computer. It contains a word processor, contains a web browser, a number of programming languages, tools for managing your files. So there's a good set of basic applications on there.
The purpose of Fedora ARM is to take individual pieces of open source software such as Apache, one of the most widely used web servers on the planet, and Firefox, which is another popular browser, and build and package them specifically to run on Fedora on a brand new hardware platform that has not really run these pieces of software before.
Fedora has a policy that software has to be built natively. It has to be built on the hardware that it's going to be used in. We needed to go out and buy a large number of ARM devices so that we could gain experience and also make sure that the software is going to work on all of them, not just one of the devices. So the build farm is a compilation of all these devices, approximately 60 builders building software for Fedora.
The build farm uses an application called Koji, and Koji is split up into a couple of parts. There is a client, which is a computer such as this. There are builders that are ARM devices like these, and then there's the main hub. A user will say, hey, I have a bit of source code that I want to be turned into an installable package. And Koji will query the farm, and it will take the package, it will compile it using the ARM toolchain so that you get a natively produced binary, and then it will give it back to Koji, which will then report back to the user, and it's ready to install and it's ready to test.
There is day-to-day maintenance, so making sure that these ARM devices are up and running, compiling software for Fedora, but also then looking at software that didn't work properly on ARM, trying to determine why it didn't work and fixing that problem. That was largely what we were doing on a day-to-day basis, is looking at key packages in the Fedora space that needed to be addressed before they would work on ARM.
The software for the Raspberry Pi in its initial incarnation has some limitations. For example, we haven't connected up the two-dimensional graphical interface to the very fast graphics hardware that's on this device yet. Initially, it will be somewhat slow. It's our hope that as more people get working with this device and more people start contributing to the effort, that we'll see fairly rapid improvements in the user experience on the device. The software that's being released initially is by no means the end of the line. We're looking forward to seeing many, many uses, some of which I'm sure nobody can even dream of right now, for this hardware as it gets into the hands of tens of thousands, in fact, maybe hundreds of thousands or millions of people over the next few years.